Hi, this is Anjaneyalu, Physics Faculty. Welcome to Narayana Online Classes. Today we are going to discuss about 8th class physics. The subtopic here is in vectors. The subtopic is parallelogram law of vector addition. So parallelogram law of vector addition. So here this is the concept. So if it is a P bar, it is also P bar. If it is a Q bar, it is also Q bar. The angle between these two vectors is theta. Now this is the diagonal of parallelogram is the parallelogram is called as a resultant of the vector. So the mathematical formula of this R bar is square root of the magnitude of this R is P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta. So this is the formula for resultant vector of these two vectors inclined with a certain angle. And if alpha is the angle between P vector and resultant vector, then tan alpha equal to Q sin theta by P plus Q cos theta. So these are the two formulae majorly we will get from the parallelogram law of vector addition. Okay, based upon this topic, now we are going to discuss some problems. The first problem is, if P bar equal to I cap plus 2j cap plus k cap and Q bar equal to minus I cap minus j cap plus 2k cap. Or inclined at an angle of 60 degree. Then find the resultant. So here answers 2 into root 3, second option 3 into root 2, third option 4, fourth option 6. Okay, for solving this problem, generally we must know the magnitudes of these two given vectors. Because according to our parallelogram law of vector addition based, the formula is so P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta, there PQ are the magnitudes. So that's why first we have to find the magnitudes of the given vectors. So P vector magnitude. So 1 is there, that's why 1 square, 1, 2 square, 4, 1 square, 1. So root 6 is the magnitude of P. And Q. So magnitude of Q is minus 1 whole square plus 1, minus 1 whole square plus 1, 2 square, 4. So root 6. So P bar value root 6 and Q bar value root 6. Okay, now the formula of resultant vector R bar equal to P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta. So here P square. So already we derived P value is root 6 and Q value is root 6. So P square, so 6, Q square, 6 plus 2 into root 6 into root 6 into cos, what is the angle between them? 60 degree. So that's why cos 60 degree. So R equal to 6 plus 6, 12 plus 2 into root 6 into root 6, 6 into cos 60, 1 by 2. So R is equal to R equal to this one cancel here this one better to cancel 2. So now here 6 is there only. So 12 plus 6, so root 18. So root 18, how we can write? R equal to 2 into 9. So the answer is 3 into root 2. So R equal to 3 into root 2. That's why second option is correct. Second problem. If P bar and Q bar are perpendicular, to each other, then the angle between P bar and resultant is first option alpha equal to tan inverse of P by Q. Second option alpha equal to tan inverse of P. Third option alpha equal to tan inverse of Q by P. And fourth option cannot say. So these are the options given. So what we given in this problem, if P bar and Q bar are perpendicular to each other. So that means if P bar is here, Q bar is along this direction, then the angle between them theta equal to 90 degree. So what is the formula for resultant angle for here? If you consider this is a parallelogram, this is the P bar, Q bar, and this is the resultant R bar. So the angle between P bar and resultant is alpha. So the basic formula is tan alpha equal to Q sin theta by P plus Q cos theta. So now here substitute theta value 90. So Q into sin 90 value 1, so 1 into Q, Q only. Next, P plus Q into cos 90, cos 90 0, 0 into Q 0. So that's why what we will get tan alpha equal to Q by P plus 0. Okay, now tan alpha equal to Q by P, alpha equal to tan inverse of Q by P. Alpha equal to tan inverse of Q by P. Alpha equal to tan inverse of Q by P. So that's why third option is correct. Next, third bit. If two vectors are in the ratio, if two vectors are in the ratio 3:5 and their resultant is 56 and angle between two vectors is angle between two vectors is 60 degree. then find these vectors. Then find these vectors. So the first option is 24, 49. Second option is 42, 24. Third option is 24, 48. Fourth option is 24, 40. Okay, so how we can solve this problem? First, if two vectors are in the ratio 3:5, we consider magnitude of P is 3x, magnitude of Q is 5x. So what is the theta value? 60, and resultant is 56. So the mathematical formula is R equal to P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta. R value 56 given, P square, so P value 3x, so P square 9x square, Q value 5x, Q square 25x square plus 2 into 3x into 5x into cos 60 degree. So 56 equal to here 9 plus 25, 34x square plus cos 60 value 1/2. So then this 2 cancel, 3x plus 5x, so it is 15x square. So now here what we will get, 56 is equal to 34 plus 15, 49x square. When it comes out, we will get 7x. So then x equal to 8. So now here 3 into 8, 24. Next 5 into 8, 40. So here not there. Here is the answer. So 24 and 40. So what is the P value? P value is 3 into 8, 24. Q value is 40. So 24, 40. Fourth option is correct. Next, fourth bit. Fourth bit. Find the resultant. Find the resultant of the given pair of vectors shown below. Magnitude of P bar 3 magnitude of Q bar is 5. Here the angle is 60 degree. So the answers here, root of 21, second option root of 29, third option root of 45, fourth option 5. Okay. Before going to solve this problem, already magnitude of P and magnitude of Q given, but what is the angle between those two vectors? So according to the diagram, even though the angle between two vectors is represented is 60, but we are not taking the theta value is 60. So what is the reason? So here the vector P is along this direction, the vector Q is along this direction. So now if it is 60 degree, then the theta, that means angle between these two vectors is 120 degree. So that's why for solving the problem, we have to take theta value 120 degree. Now the formula is R equal to P square plus Q square plus 2PQ cos theta. Okay, R equal to P square, so 3, that's why 9 plus Q square 25 plus 2 into 3 into 5 into, so here cos 120 value minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2. So R is equal to here 34, this one cancel, minus 15. So the 34, so here what we will get, 34 minus 15. So 34, 15. So here I think it is not. So answer is 90. So answer is 90. So fourth option is correct. Okay. Thank you.